What's really cool about this technology is that we can radically change the fitting process for prosthetics. At the moment, there are multiple consultations. It can take months before somebody actually gets their prosthetic. Somebody could order a prosthetic for us on a Monday and receive it on the Friday without ever meeting with us. And that's huge for kids, for instance, who are in school and don't want to be taken out of school, or their parents don't want them to be taken out of school. The way the process works is that somebody would select the prosthesis that they want on our website digitally, and we would then send them a 3D scanner, which is very easy to use. They can use that to take a 3D scan of their limb and send it back to us and send the data back to us, along with some photos of their limb so that we get a good idea of how to fit it. We can then use the 3D model to make a perfectly fitted prosthesis that we can 3D print, assemble, and then send back to them. It's perfect for one-off manufacture, and prosthetics are always one-offs. They're custom fitted each time. And so even though 3D printing might be expensive for high volume manufacture, if you're just making one-offs, it's actually really cost effective.
About 2 years ago, I went and helped a friend's Kickstarter, and then on the side it said Kickstarters you might be interested in, and I read 3D printing bionic hands, low cost. I wanted a robotic hand. I was like, I've got to check this out. I started testing. It's just the little things that really make a huge difference. And one thing for me is also shaking with my right hand. So I was only born with my left. So yeah, it's pretty amazing. And then shaking people with the arm and their expressions are just amazing.
What kind of expressions do you get?
Most people either think that I'm doing it for some sort of cosplay and they're like, that's not a robotic hand. I'm like, yes it is. And then especially with this new prototype from Deus Ex, the Adam Jensen arm, some people are just like, you're not wearing that. And I'm like, you know, they're just mind blown. And I love seeing it because it's just so it's such a nice positive way to see things. So instead of going, oh, what happened to your arm? Or, you know, if you're wearing one of the old prosthetics, like the ones I used to have that didn't do much, they go, oh, how did you lose your arm? Instead they're like, what is this? How does it work? Can I have one, kind of thing? And it's so much more positive and I love it.
We wanted to make our prosthetics affordable because we discovered that a lot of the, particularly the more advanced prosthetics that are available now, are very, very expensive, prohibitively expensive for most people to have access to them.
There has to be some compromises, right?
Yeah, no. The proper marketing answer would be, no, we've made it even better. In the research and development process for our bionic hand, we spoke to hundreds of different limb different people, and we tried to find out their priorities in terms of what features they really needed from their prosthetics and their bionics, and what compromises we might be able to make in the design to save money and make it affordable. And so we found that they really needed something that was really lightweight and comfortable to wear. That's the most important thing, and something that made them feel really good about themselves and about their limb difference. And so we've really focused on those things. The other thing they really needed was great functionality, because otherwise it wouldn't be providing them a benefit. One of the compromises that we made in terms of the performance of the hand is ours isn't quite as strong in grip strength as some of the leading competitors, but we've made sure that it's strong enough to be able to handle all sorts of household objects and things that we've asked people what they wanted to do and use it for. We're working on making the hand as strong as possible, but without having to spend extra money. The really cool thing about the partnership with Deus Ex is that it's got people thinking about prosthetics in a slightly different way. So where previously they might have thought about them as medical products, now people are looking at it as something that's additional, that, you know, they don't need a replacement for anything, they're whole as they are, but they have the possibility to wear this additional really cool device that gives them extra capabilities that they didn't have before. I first started working with bionic hands, or robotic hands, when I was about 17, tinkering at home, and then I took the project to university where I developed it a bit further. And at that point I kind of started to recognize that there was a demand for this product as a bionic hand and as a prosthetic. And at around the same time, 3D printing was becoming a more accessible technology.
So this was like one of the very first prototypes that I made, which is like obviously very rudimentary and just pieces of cut up aluminium. This was the first one that Dan wore. This was all 3D printed, but you can see like super bulky, and we had to make it bigger to fit all of the electronics and stuff inside. We started using flexible materials to make it more robust and to make the manufacture easier, which was very effective. this is kind of a next iteration. This is a kid's version. This is actually the smallest multi-grip myoelectric prosthesis that to our knowledge, anyone's ever worn.
When I was a kid, I used to have a prosthetic that didn't do much. And what it was, they put stickers of, because I asked, I got the stickers myself, and we put loads of Simpsons stickers on it. That was as customized as it got back then. So when I showed, especially this arm I'm wearing right now, the actual reaction is, it's overwhelming for me, because like when I was a kid, I dreamt of this. I literally thought, oh, one day this might happen, but I never thought it'd happen. And I'm, you know, here right now showing you guys what it's like.
At the moment, it looks like the biggest cost for the product is going to be in the time spent manufacturing it and assembling it. And that's something that, as technology improves, we can streamline even further. So as 3D scanning technology gets better, as our software becomes further developed, we can automate certain processes, and then we can streamline the development even further, so it's even faster and even more cost effective. In the next 6 months, we're gearing up to do a broader scale clinical trial. So we can't give an exact release date at the moment, but because we don't necessarily know what's going to happen with the next testing phases and the clinical trials, but we're aiming for a release date in 2017.